Thank you. Before we get started, as we witness this marriage between Danielle and Nicholas as they start their life together, we recognize the separate gifts that they bring to this marriage as people. And the persons that they are today are in no small part due to the love, care, and support they receive from their mothers. Their mothers carry them into this world, and with their fathers were their first teachers. So now I'm going to invite Lee and Donna to light two candles to represent those persons that come to the altar today.
May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you. The earth is good, full of the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we ought to put up with the failings of the weak and not to please ourselves. Let each of us please our neighbor for the good, for building up, for Christ did not please himself. May the God of endurance and encouragement grant you to think in harmony with one another, in keeping with Christ Jesus, that with one accord you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another then as Christ has welcomed you, for the glory of the Lord. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. One of the Pharisees, a scholar of the law, tested Jesus by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord. What image do we have of God? How does God enter our lives? As human persons, most of us have an idea of who God is. We have a picture of how we see him in our mind's eye. And this has been going on from the beginning of time. The first two chapters of Genesis give us two different images of God. In the first creation story, in the first chapter, we hear of God as all-powerful. He creates by just saying the word, "Let there be light," and there is light, and the light is good. We see him out there in the heavens. You know, in the past few years, we've been getting pictures from space, from the Hubble telescope. We've been seeing things from that, of nebulas and stars and galaxies and things that I don't understand. These pictures are so beautiful of creation. And in some way, when we see those pictures, we can see the face of God. The connection we have with him is creation, and the connection that we have in that creation. The second chapter of Genesis paints a picture of God being in the garden, and that is the reading that we heard, the first reading today, was God in the garden. He was in the garden with man and woman, and he's in the garden with us too, helping us and them along the way. And the picture we might have in our mind's eye of God is that gardener with the straw hat and the long sleeves and maybe an apron. Those things, that God that is with us in the garden daily. We might picture him like that neighbor lady who suits up to go out to tend her flowers. Now, these two images that we have are not contradictory, they're complementary. At one and the same time, God is out in the heavens, and he is all powerful, and he does create, and he does have action just through the word. But God is with us, and he's inside us, and he's within us in every breath that we take. The story from Genesis that we heard tells us how God created man and woman by forming them out of clay and breathing into them his life. And God is so close to us that he is in every breath. The writer tells us of an image of God who is on the journey with us as he was with that first man, as he was with Nicholas and Danielle, helping them find that one person who will make them happy, finding that one person that they can come together with to form one new life. Man and woman, as husband and wife, are meant to go through life side by side. Neither is to be ahead or behind, or above or below. They go on life's journey as equals. A husband and wife are first called to friendship, and friendship grows into love. St. Paul tells us in Romans letter that to live in God's love requires us to have a welcoming attitude. When we welcome someone into our homes, we don't stop them at the curb. We don't stop them at the porch. We allow them to come into the house, and we sit down around the table and have a meal, or we sit in the living room and have a discussion and share. When a couple pledges their love, they welcome each other into their life and form a new life. They become one, and in some way, their separate lives up to now are put aside. And there can be many people in our life, but there will only be that one special person, our companion. That is the one who we will share thoughts, our dreams, our fears, and our wants. Now, the love we give each other, especially the love that we share with our spouse, is the love that God has given to us in our hearts, and we are just passing it on. And we do not have the ability to love truly without having God in our life. Now, this is a love that goes beyond words. But when we do use words, they are soft ones. When a husband has to leave his wife for the day or just for a little short time, he says, for only a moment to you, I love you. And love is communicated by a hug, a kiss, a gentle brush of the hand on her arm, or in the loving way a wife places her hand on his shoulder, reassuring her that he is the one that she loves. And as a result of a husband and wife's physical love, the child is born. And in that way, they really and truly become one flesh. Their love will be carried on to the next generation in a most blessed way. And it is God's love that allows us to do this. We can tell when a couple loves each other. We can tell how they look at each other. We see how their hands naturally come together. We see a gentle touch on the arm or shoulder that tells the other, I love you. Nicholas and Danielle, you will will be making your promises to each other very soon. But it will not end there. Each day, you will decide to live your vows and love each other, to share the love God has given to each of you with the other, to be content with each other, because each of you is a gift from God to the other. It is my hope, and I know it is the hope of everyone who is gathered here today, that you may have many joys and few sorrows, and that over the years, you will grow even closer to each other, so that when you are apart, you feel like something is missing from your heart. So now it is time to make your promises. Let us continue in prayer and thanksgiving to the God who has given us his love.
Nicholas, take you, Danielle, to be my wife.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
In sickness and health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Danielle, take you, Nicholas, to be my husband.
I, Danielle, take you, Nicholas, to be my husband.
I promise to be true to you in good times and bad.
I promise to be good to you in good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you all the days of our life.
I will love you and honor you all the days of our life.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessing. What God has joined, men must not divide. Lord, bless these rings which we bless in vain. Grant that those who wear them may always have deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Nicholas, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Nicholas, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
For all married persons, that they they may continue to give, be able to forgive, and find happiness deepened within the passing of each day. Let us pray to the Lord. For Nicholas and Danielle, now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm, loving, reaching out to others, and good health until a ripe old age. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or oppressed, that they may be strengthened by God's help and aided by their friends. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of Danielle and Nicholas, and all present for this wedding, that they may enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord. For these personal needs, which we mention now in silence, let us pray to the Lord.
May God, the Almighty Father, give you his joy and bless you. May the only Son of God have mercy upon you and help you in good times and bad. May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with his love. And may Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, of introducing to you for the very first time, Mr.